Hello everybody and welcome to another episode of Stable Diffusion Experimental. Today we'll be taking a look at colors. Not of the what's your favorite color variety, but of the models variety. Because as it turns out, a couple of weeks ago, Kolors, which claims to be a base model, was developed and released by the Kuaishu Kolors team. And what's interesting about it is not the base model per se, but the claims about its prompt adherence, color fidelity, general prompt understanding, and the release of a new version of IPAdapter that has been optimized for use with Kolors. And to be quite honest, the results are pretty great, both with style transfer and linear, as we can see here, and both at high weights and relatively lower weights. And again, both in terms of style transfer and linear weight types. So why are we looking at this model today? Well, because most of the production pipelines that I build, and I'm sure other people build as well, are often based on IPAdapters, amongst other things, of course, but IPAdapter has been a godsend. So having access to a new version of an IPAdapter is quite a big deal for some of us, or at least it would be if the licensing was a bit clearer. More on that later. We'll talk about the licensing in due time, but for now let's dive into this workflow here, and same as always, you will be able to find this workflow in the description below, as well as any other models or custom notes you might need. The way that Kolors work is slightly different from the usual SDXL checkpoint, even if it appears to be based at least loosely on SDXL. First of all, we are loading the checkpoint from unit instead of the checkpoints folder, and so we need a unit loader. In the description below, you'll find a download link for this model. I have renamed it to Kolors Unit just to remember it better. Another different thing that you might find here is that the clip text encodes are not the usual clip text encodes that you are used to. They are actually a mix of a clip text encode and an LLM. What it's basically doing is it's using an LLM, in this case ChatGLM3, in order to prepare the conditioning a bit better. So in order for all of this to work, you cannot use your normal pipelines, your normal clip text encodes nodes, but you have to use these nodes. And you also have to use the ChatGLM3 model. Again, link in the description below. Then we have the usual case sampler and empty latent image, but you can also do image to image, of course, by using an image and encoding it. But then we have a bit of a blast from the past. I haven't used a separate loader for VAEs in a hot minute, but since this UNet model doesn't have a VAE baked in, we have to load a VAE separately. And the VAE that we are using is the SDXL VAE. And that's it for the basic text to image portion of the workflow. But if we take a look at the top here, we have our IPAdapter pipeline. Now, those of you who are already familiar with IPAdapters will recognize the structure. We have the IPAdapter Advanced node, which is basically the same as the one from Matteo, but instead of using a unified loader, which in Matteo's case basically takes care of the pairings between IPAdapter models and ClipVision models, we have to load both the IPAdapter model and the ClipVision model separately. So once again, you'll be able to find both of these models in the description below. And in the case of the IPAdapter model, I have renamed it to IPAdapter Plus Kolors, and the ClipVision model, I have renamed it to ClipVision Kolors. It's just easier for me to remember that way. Then, same as with all of the IPAdapter pipelines, we have to load one or more images into it. In this case, I am loading just one image. I am using a lowish weight, 0.6 in this case, a weight type linear, but I can swap that out for style transfer, for example, and then I'm hitting Q prompt. Now, bear in mind that the IPAdapter Advanced node only sees a square image. So in case your image is not square like this one, it's going to see only the square at the center of the image. So if you have important stuff happening over here on top or down here, IPAdapter is not going to be able to see that. You might want to resize the image in order to get those details or subjects as well. Now, as you can see, the results are pretty good, but are they better than the usual IPAdapter that we are using already? Well, in order to answer that, let's compare two workflows side by side. On the left, we have the Kolors one, and on the right, we have the usual one with an XDXL model. In this case, that's Juggernaut V9, and the usual IPAdapter Plus by Matteo. Let me zoom in a bit so you can check that out for yourself. We have the Juggernaut model here, the IPAdapter Advanced Plus here, the same prompt, the same seed. It's set on incremental, same variables everywhere. And right now, both of them are on style transfer. So once again, left Kolors, right as the XL. As you can see here, the adherence to the original image, I think, is much stronger in the Kolors version. And even as we keep generating, we can see that the results from Kolors are much more adherent to the original image. Now, that could be a bit unfair because the original IPAdapter Plus has been set to style transfer, and so it's supposed to only be transferring the style of the image rather than the person in it. So let's switch that out to linear. I'm gonna switch that to linear over here, switch that to linear here as well, and let's do some more testing. Okay, now for linear, we are getting closer. While the person on the left, which is Kolors, is much closer to the person in the reference image, person on the right is not as far anymore, at least from a feelings perspective. I feel like the one on the left is much closer to the reference image, but we actually have a way to compare them, and that's by using a face analysis models like Inside Face and a face embeds distance node. I won't bother you with all the details about this. If you want to know more about how to compare two faces, I will leave a link to a very, very good video by Matteo in the description below. It's absolutely phenomenal if you are into face transfer. So now, if we cue prompt again and check out the results we got here in the overlay, we can see some values. The values go from 0.0 to 1.0, and better results are the results that are furthest away from 1. So ideally you want to go for 0, but the current models and nodes that we have now will not allow that. The best we usually can achieve is around 0.45, 0.5, 0.6. In this case, the one on the left, the Kolors one, achieved a value of 0.761, whereas the one on the right achieved a value of 0.833. So it appears that in this case, the Kolors IPAdapter works better than the usual SDXL IPAdapter. Same as here, where we got a 0.762 on the left, the Kolors one, and a 0.836 on the one on the right, the SDXL one, the usual one. Or this case, where the results are pretty much the same in terms of value, a 0.774 on the left for Kolors and a 0.777 on the right for SDXL. If we switch over to style transfer though, the results change dramatically. We can see that on the left we got 0.76, while on the right we got a 0.854. And here we got a 0.628 on the left for Kolors and a 0.784 on the right for SDXL and the usual IPAdapter. Now, of course, these are only numeric values that analyze faces and faces only. They tell us nothing about the overall style transfer of the picture or the overall composition, colors, etc. So this is just to analyze how closely a face resembles its reference. Now, of course, here I am using just one picture for reference, but you can use more than one. Like in these examples, where I'm using these two images of the same person that I found on Pexels, and I'm using them both as reference in a linear weight scenario. And here the Kolors IPAdapter once again takes the cake with a value of 0.633 against a value of 0.803 for the usual SDXL IPAdapter that we already use. Now, of course, this is an IPAdapter, you don't have to use it for people only. You can use it for a plethora of stuff, like in this case where I'm using a Totoro image for a reference for an anime illustration, and once again I feel like the new Kolors IPAdapter kind of takes the cake. But since it looks like it's better, why are we not using it? Well, that's because of licensing. If we go back to the Ugly Face page of Kolors, we will see that there is a fair bit of confusion in terms of licensing. On the one hand, right under license, the Kolors theme says that it's open source for academic research, and for commercial use you would have to fill out a questionnaire and send it to the team. But regardless of this small issue, which is not that small, that the questionnaire is in Chinese, and this is usually not a great thing to do in terms of time-sensitive projects, regardless of the language of the questionnaire. Right below it, the team says that they open source Kolors to promote the development of large text-to-image models in collaboration with the open source community, and that the code of this project is open sourced under the Apache 2.0 license. Now, the Apache 2.0 license doesn't restrict commercial use. The license agreement itself doesn't resemble an Apache 2.0 license. And that is why this video is Stable Diffusion Experimental and not Stable Diffusion for Professional Creatives, because I would not suggest using this, both the base model and the new IP adapter, for any commercial work out there, unless until the license agreement portion of it is laid out a bit better. And regarding this, I would really love to say my two cents. I realize, because I work in this field, that there's a lot of money to be made in generative AI right now. But cloaking oneself under the guise of open source, while at the same time restricting the commercial usage of things that you do and create and release to the public, is not great. I would be perfectly fine with projects that are non-commercial and have a clear and precise path to commercialization. In my line of work as a fashion photographer, we have contracts that are pretty clear about what we can and cannot do commercially. We use commercial software all the time. The usages are pretty clear cut for us. There's open source stuff that we can freely use, both commercially and non-commercially, and there's stuff that we cannot use in any way, shape, or form commercially, or there's stuff that has a very clear path to commercial use. Why can't it be the same in this space as well? I'm not saying this for Kolors only. I'm saying this for Stability AI as well, or any other project out there that wants to be seen as open source while still withholding commercial use. While there is a small community of open source diehards who'd fight you tooth and nail if you release something with non-commercial licensing, there's a ton of professionals out there who do not care at all about something being completely open source or not. They just want to have a way to use something commercially. They don't want to fill out questionnaires. They don't want to send emails to random teams. They don't want to have to wait for a personalized reply. They want to know when and if they have to pay for commercial use of something and how can they pay to access it. The first time I heard about SD3's commercial license, I thought, well, that's pretty stupid. Why can't they use something like Unreal Engine's license, where it's open to everyone under $1 million of revenue, which is pretty clear cut. And lo and behold, they did just that. So yes, you don't have to reinvent the wheel is already there and it works, it's round and it rolls down the street perfectly fine, we don't need any other shapes, and that's the end of my rant. So even if it's for academic purposes only, I hope you have fun with this new IP adapter. I'll be sure to test it out more, and I really hope that Matteo can implement some of this stuff on their IP adapter as well. If you liked this video, leave a like and subscribe. I want to thank once again all of the new supporters on Ko-fi. My name is Andrea Baioni. You can find me on Instagram at reasonobushi or on the web at andreabaioni.com. And same as always, I will be seeing you next week.